上帝给人类有一个怀疑的头脑。
That's why God gave human beings a mind that can doubt.
法国的哲学家 René Descartes 他讲有两种怀疑。
The French philosopher René Descartes said there are two kinds of skepticism.
第一种的怀疑是因为要怀疑，所以就怀疑。
The first type of skepticism is skepticism for its own sake.
第二种的怀疑，因为要相信，遇到太多困难，所以怀疑。
The second kind of skepticism is they want to believe, but they've come up against a lot of questions, and so they have to ask.
第二种的怀疑，你要 tackle。你要好好地对付他。
You must tackle this second kind of skepticism very well.
把这些的怀疑找出一条出路出来。
To find a way for these skeptics.
那教会就可以免去许多的损失。
Only then can the church avoid losing any more of its people.
那当一个人有许多问题要怀疑的时候，
When someone has a lot of questions,
你要真正找出他怀疑的基础到底是什么。
You have to probe into what is the foundation of the skepticism.
有一种的怀疑是很可怕的。
There is one kind of skepticism that is terrible.
撒旦投资式的怀疑。
And that is the kind of skepticism that is invested in by Satan.
上帝对亚当的第一句话是什么呢？
What did God say to Adam?
这棵树你不可吃。
You cannot eat of the fruit of this tree.
你吃这棵树的果子的那一天，你必定死。
Because the day you eat of this fruit, you will die.
所以这句话就是上帝的道的警戒性。
This is God's warning in His word.
隐藏着上帝的公义的审判性。
This incorporates God's judgment and His righteousness.
带着上帝命令的权威性在里面。
This is a statement with God's authority in it.
对这句话，撒旦的回应是什么呢？
What was Satan's response to that command?
上帝说你不可以吃。
God says you cannot eat.
你吃的日子必定死。
Because that day you eat it, you will die.
当时亚当还没有吃。
At that time, Adam did not eat.
当时亚当也不知道死是什么。
Adam did not even know what death meant.
这隐藏的上帝的话是超过人的经验的。
Because inside God's words meaning transcends the human experience at the time.
如果亚当曾经活过，又曾经死过。
If Adam had lived and died,
那么他听这句话就有一种比较。
Then when he hears this command, he has a comparative framework.
但亚当没有死过。
But Adam had never died.
所以他根本不知道上帝讲这句话到底意思是什么。
So he has no clue about what God is talking about.
因为死是他未曾经历的事情。
Because he had never experienced death at that point.
就在这种未曾经历的限制的经验里面，
and in his limited experience,
魔鬼跑出来了。
Satan comes in.
他把这句话改成另外一种话。
So he distorts this into another statement.
上帝说，
God said,
撒旦说上帝岂是真说。
Satan says, did God say this?
上帝说你必定死。
God said, you will die.
撒旦说你不一定死。
Satan says, "You may not die."
创世纪第三章
Genesis chapter 3
就是多元主义的开始
is the beginning of pluralism.
怀疑主义的开始
the beginning of skepticism.
相对主义的开始
the beginning of relativism.
就这个自由发挥到不照真理的顺从的那种自由的放纵的开始
it became the permitted freedom that is not within the realm of God.
我年轻的时候
when I was young,
我就很想我年老的时候专写一本书论到创世纪第三章
I wanted to write a book just on Genesis chapter 3.
在这些历史里面相对主义多元主义怀疑主义这些的东西就是历史思想的主流
because those schools of thoughts are the mainstreams of the history of philosophy.
这些的种子都在创世纪第三章里面隐藏。
Yet the seeds of these schools all start with Genesis chapter 3.
撒旦的相对跟怀疑主义是用什么话表达出来的？
So how does he express his relativism and his skepticism?
就制造另外一种权威。
And that is he creates another kind of authority.
来反对单元的神而来的权威。
And this authority is in defiance of the authority that comes from one God.
上帝说。
God said,
上帝岂是真说
Did God really say?
说变成不一定真的说
From saying to maybe he did not say it.
死变成不一定会死
From death to becoming maybe you may not die.
所以这个反对权威的就是一个新的权威。
So this new anti-authority became a new kind of authority.
每一个反对权威的这个新的种子就隐藏着另外一个新权威的开始。
Anybody who is anti-authority is in it, embedded in it, the seeds of another kind of authority.
亚当夏娃在这件事情上，他们只注意到吃不吃对我有什么好处，没有注意到权威不权威对我有什么影响。
In looking at this, Adam and Eve was thinking about, should I eat it or should I not eat it? What's in it for me? Instead of saying, what kind of authority do I obey?
在相对的权威一出现的时候，
so when a relative authority shows up,
人就变成有两条路了。
Now you have two pathways.
本来走一条路就对了。
Originally there's only one way.
现在 alternative 另外一条路跑生出来了。
Now suddenly there's another way.
所以这时候的思潮就进入 either or 的可能性里面。
So it became an either or proposition.
Either or 是从第三章开始的。
So either or comes from chapter 3.
Either or 发展的最丰富的时候就十九世纪奇克果的哲学。
Either or found its apex in the 19th century philosopher Kierkegaard.
到了二十世纪七十年代的时候。
And when we get to the 1970s,
人在新或者后现代里面产生了 neither nor 的思想。
And now with postmodernism, we now have neither nor.
那 neither nor 的思想在圣经早就存在了。
And neither nor already existed in the Bible.
所以我们没有研究哲学。更没有把圣经的权威跟所有这些思潮做比较的，你不知道神的话多么伟大。
So unless you have studied philosophy and looked at how the Bible fits into this, you will not understand the greatness of the Word of God.
许多的人就因为在整个传统的教育里面
，A lot of people just go through a traditional educational experience.
他们从来没有好好比较。
They've never compared.
所以他们就接受了老师教导他的有些的东西，就这样囫囵吞枣的把它接受进去了。
Basically, they just swallow whatever the professor tells them, and they just take it.
当